convection. This mechanism of energy transfer is more common in liquid and gases, that is fluids. So how does this happens is, in liquids, the molecules or particles are slightly away from each other, but still very closely packed with each other, due to which these molecules or particles can actually translate within the liquid. Like these particles can move, change their position. This atom or this particle can move all the way here. This atom is free to move within the liquid. And occasionally, these particles also escape from the surface of the liquid, even though there is a kind of tension, a kind of a membrane on the top of every liquid that tries to restrict these atoms or molecules inside the liquid. That's called surface tension. But we are not getting towards the surface tension today. But what we see is, inside the liquid, there is no force that keeps the liquid, these molecules, to move away from each, that restricts the motion of molecules. Okay, so these molecules or particles can move inside the liquid. As compared to liquid, in gases, the atoms or molecules have higher distance between them. So these molecules are almost free to move anywhere they want to go. So in gases, molecules have very large distance between them, and in liquid, the distance, intramolecular distance are small as compared to gases, but they are still large as compared to solids. Okay, so when we provide energy from thermal energy, thermal energy store of these particles, what happens is these molecules, the energy like conduction moves to the kinetic energy stores of the particles, and they try to move away from each other. So due to which, if these particles receive energy, now initially if the distance was d between them, now the distance will increase by d plus some distance e. So the distance will eventually increase. Now if the distance between the particle increases, the density will decrease. Density is how closely packed the atoms or particles are. So if the atom or particle are not very closely packed, the density will be low. If they are very close to each other, the density will be high. So the density will reduce, and we know that materials with low density, they try to go up, and high density things try to come down. So like if you throw something in water which has the density higher than water, it will sink. But if its density is lower than water, it will float. So is the case with the air. The particles, now the same particle of the gas, have low density as compared to these particles. Or in liquid, the particle of the liquid have low density here as compared to these particles. Due to the change in density, these particles will move to the up direction, and higher density particle will take this place, and this will happen to all the particles which have more thermal energy in their thermal energy store. They will try to move up, and the particles with low thermal energy, they will come down. Now what happens when these particles go up and these particles come down? There is a source which is continuously providing thermal energy to the particles. Due to this thermal energy, these particles are getting more energy, and their density reduces. Meanwhile, let's say these particles, we have some kind of lid here, they collide with this or the wall of the container, and they dissipate, they transfer their energy to their surroundings or to the top of the container, and their energy decreases. The energy from their kinetic energy store is taken by these contacts, due to which their density again increases, and they come down again, and these particles move up. This is called convection currents. Okay, so these are called convection currents, that the particles are continuously moving up and down. So when we turn the radiator on in our room, the air particle near the radiator surface absorb thermal energy from the radiator. They go because of absorbing thermal energy, they move up to the roof and they transfer their energy to the roof, and then the particle with lower thermal energy come down, and that's how it keeps circulating within the material, and that's how the energy is transferred. So in convection, the energy is transferred via particle to from particle to particle, but the transfer of energy takes place by the actual movement of the particle. So what we see is we got a energy box here, or a pile of energy boxes, and now particles are behaving like these carriers. Okay, so they get energy, they go away, the load off their energy, they come back. Meanwhile, particles that don't have energy with them, they come back here, they come here, they get energy, they go there, and the circle continues, and this circle is called convectional currents. Okay, so that was about the transfer of energy and the thermal energy stores of the materials, even though we have another kind of mechanism for energy transfer, that is radiation, in which we don't need the solid, liquid or gases. For example, energy from sun in the form of thermal energy reaches us, and we don't have a large space between sun and earth. Is vacuum, there is no solid, liquid and gas, but energy still gets to transfer, and that's why we say for radiation we don't need any medium to transfer of for the transfer of energy from sun to earth. Okay.